For our second sewing 101, we are going to sew this patch onto this piece of fabric. We're gonna assume that there's a tear under there, or that maybe I just want it to look like that. So we're going to thread the needle, and I'm gonna go through this a little bit faster than the last video, but I folded it in half, and then I'm gonna stick it through the eye of the needle, just like that. I do not want to have a knot on the back, so I'm going to go ahead and keep my tails out. Again, you want it about an arm's length. If you get much more than that, you'll start tangling, and then lots of unfortunate words will come out of your mouth. So we are going to pull our ends to more or less match each other. Nobody is coming along and measuring anything. And if they are, they're the jerks, and you don't have to worry about it. And we're gonna move our needle down towards that end. Oops. So now I have my threaded needle. It's double over. So I'm gonna go towards the end, and I'm gonna come up from behind and pull up. We are not gonna go all the way through. We're just gonna hold that down. And then I'm gonna go down and make sure that that loop goes around my needle. Hopefully you can see it there. And then pull it through. That makes for a nice solid start. No bumps. So we're gonna do what's called a running stitch now. So you're gonna come up, and the distance on these stitches is really up to you and what your purposes are. The closer that the stitches are to each other, the firmer everything is going to hold. That can be a positive, but if you've got like really fine fabrics, that could be a negative, because then your stitch line is stronger than everything else, and so then that will create an area of failure. I like it about this length, which is probably somewhere between an eighth and a quarter of an inch. It's long enough that it doesn't take me forever to finish a line, but it is short enough it's not going to be catching. It's going to be fairly stable. So the easy way to do a running stitch is actually kind of fun, I think, and it's a little bit flip-floppy. So I've got it coming up. I didn't pull it all the way through. I'm going to go dive back down, and then I'm going to come back up. So I'm making these little pleats. And you just keep doing that. And there's no particular rhyme or reason to how long or how far, just until you're done. And then you pull it through, and you pull through relatively gently. The nice thing about that is, if you notice, the ones where I was going in and out are much straighter than when I was coming full up and full down. You can mark a line if you wanted to with pencil. Pencil will just wash right out. Or you can, sometimes you can use fabric markers that are washable, but that's an extra expense that I choose not to do for the most part. Or you can just eyeball it and tell everybody it's rustic and that's how you meant for it to be, and they won't know the difference. So there we go with this one line. Oops. And if you pull too hard, then you'll get a nice gather, which it can be something that you want, but I don't this time. So to do a knot, there's a couple different things that you can do. The one I generally try to do, or I like to do, is you take a small bite, is what we call it, out of the fabric. So it's just a tiny little bit. It's enough to make sure that you've got a piece of the fabric without being this giant area. And so I pull it almost all the way through, and I have this little loop here. So I pull the needle through that. I pull my old loop down, and I pull until I have this little loop again, and I pull my needle through that, and then I pull it tight and cut it off close. And you've just double knotted it.